Πώς ήταν τελικά?
Χωρίς εσύ.
Αντισονάν.
Thank you.
started and speaking for the instructions.
Okay, so
you can leave your box down and enjoy. A month. Tell us why you're leaving.
Oh my God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You should tell to the public the reason you're leaving. You were told you were going to be asked for a feedback, a critique.
Yes.
So, just, not us, the public.
Do you hear? It's not getting so interesting for me, and
it's just like dividing.
And it's like dividing. I don't like that.
No.
Okay, so you should just come. We can talk about it.
I don't want to talk.
Do you think that it's dividing?
I don't like to.
Yeah, I agree.
Do this kind of
thing. We can resolve this separation. Maybe we can find another way to get to that. Do you have a suggestion?
Just read the book.
Just read the book all together?
No, not together, just by yourself.
I can hear, what can we hear? To get to know each other.
Just being comfortable. Are you not comfortable here? We just want to live. That's fine.
Okay, no? Thank you, bye.
Thanks.
So nobody went to the conference. Okay, so there are 9 people outside that want to join our group, and I suggest that people that want to accept them should go this way, and people that don't want us to accept them should go this way. What? Okay, we accept you.
We're here to make music.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this is your score. This is the score. So it tells you everything you need to know.
Last night, I was talking with a psychologist, and he mentioned a new phrase, which is one of our group. And he mentioned a new phrase that was emerging in our society. Narcissism, which mixes narcissism and nihilism or cynicism. Yeah. What do you think about that?
I think Trump needs a bit of that.
I think Trump is an easy scapegoat, but what about ourselves? What about everybody around us?
It's just the blatant narcissism.
Okay.
Don't sit down.
I don't know anything. What do I know?
You don't know? What is this? Can you explain it?
Maybe the psychologist.
But it's important to say your point of view.
But you shouldn't sit. You should stand up because we're in the middle of a game.
Stand up. Everybody.
Stand up.
Yeah.
How are you going to become one with the others if half of them are sitting and half of them are standing?
The point is to become one.
That's the last imperative on the score you're holding. That's the last instruction on the score you're holding.
Thank you.
Yeah, we can leave. We were going to look like for a place where we could like leave somebody. We were looking for a place where we could like leave our friends, but now we found it.
Your friend? This friend? What's your name?
My name is Miguel. Yeah.
I think they, like
they don't like me. No, they do. I think the first thing we need to understand and accept is that we don't have any control over our lives. And that most of the things that we think are real are imagined realities. A lot of the things that's
going on. By the way, so we are on a vacation trip, and the title is Ephemeral Dialogue. So whatever we say will disappear. Without trace.
Female dialogue?
No, ephemeral. Ephemeral.
So we talk a lot of ephemeral stuff. And also, fatness is inspiring. For what? For conversations, for having a symposium.
Money is not the biggest thing.
Why do you guys think it's so difficult for us to relinquish control of our lives?
I don't think it's difficult.
So what's your secret? Because a lot of people, you know, want to manage their lives.
What's the secret of managing our life? Are there any secrets? Is that different people have different ways to manage their lives? And I think it's not, there's only one way
I think different people have different ways to go through their path of things. Maybe it's not in the terms of control, but just go with the flow of things. And I don't think it's very difficult.
Well, what does the good life look like? What does the collective good life look like? I mean, surely some people are living better lives than others.
Maybe we should define what is good first. There are some bad things happening in good lives. We should raise those bad things, and difficulties come, and we cannot compare your good life to others' good lives. There's different standards.
Okay, let's make this conversation a little bit more collective, and let's continue what we were doing. Like, we can split into two groups, and people that think that they have control of their lives could go over there, and people that think that they don't have control of their lives could go over there.
Okay,
now that the group has decided that has no control over their lives, maybe we can split into two groups, like who are pleased by what the non-controlling situations in their lives have brought them. Okay, who are pleased with their lives, who are not pleased with their lives?
Pleased with their lives?
There.
Who are happy with their lives and don't have problems. So far.
That's it?
Obviously.
So would you explain why you are not peaceful life?
hours.
Yeah.
Yes?
I'm bored.
You're bored.
Me too.
I've got no opportunities.
Me neither.
And I don't see a future for myself.
Okay.
I'm a little more optimistic, but yeah. And you?
I'm poor, I have a crap job, and I have to emigrate.
Where are you from?
Ireland.
And where do you live?
Dublin.
And you?
Same.
So all of you said that you're poor, right? Was that the first thing you identified?
Yeah.
So material wealth and stability is the essence of a happy life, right? Because you chose to say that first over everything else.
Yeah.
How
is your financial situation?
My finance? I have savings, I have a job. I mean, I don't think I have to worry about that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why are you all happy with your lives? You weirdos.
I'm in love.
You're in love.
Well, I think it depends on how you describe luck. If you describe luck coming out of yourself, then it's maybe hard. If you define luck compared to others, then I think it's more easy. So I think living in my country and what I'm doing and having the opportunities I have relatively luck. If I had born in another part or maybe in another social class, for example, in my own country, maybe had been far more difficult. Sure.
I'm just a tool. I'm just a system tool.
Have any of you given birth?
That's a personal question.
I'm sure full pain is
very
good.
What?
I'm meant to
have the same thing like that.
Thank you.
strike?
I think there was a protest, yeah. Can you speak a little louder, please?
I will put my voice in. Oh. It's easy. The tachycardia affects your lungs and degrades your body slowly. You can have intercourse with your people. The medicine we have to take day in and day out destroys us even more. So we go on trips for like a week or that to get a bit more. Get a bit of sun to feel better and to talk about lives and skin to not hurt. It's weakening our bodies in a way and degrading the person. And then it's like around where I was saying age group as well. So it seems to be a thing that scientists are saying is prevalent in your mid-20s. And a lot of women.
Singular events are related to pain.
Because
worst happened in the community, but the other is winning. And the beginning to us is like, we understand this commentary without it, that it was not being understanding that. But then actually she's telling me herself that this is so true. It's like the pain that you feel today, oh, if something worse happens, then you forget this pain and the new pain becomes. So that's why I choose that philosophy. Because I concentrate on the pain that I feel, that will be the next thing that will make me forget. It's like the same way as feeling more grateful about things than feeling upset about what you don't get makes me feel that in fact if I feel grateful, it will mean that things that, if I feel upset about things, if I concentrate on upset, things will just keep upsetting me more and more. Because it's obviously, I think the life circles are similar in terms of the emotions of people, but it's what we choose to see, whether we choose to see the light or the darkness. And I'm not talking about people who don't have capacity because of their emotional state, who like have certain, another mental condition that it's difficult for them to see the light and they need much more support. You know, but if by my own choice, being a mentally healthy person, I choose to see the darkness over action and over changing, that means that I'm not trying to change them.
Well, have you noticed how we also take on, we realize emotions are, I mean, they exist in a huge range of things. We're constantly moving through a whole set of emotions. If in your world and in your life, your emotional register, anybody who's very positive all the time, you need to kill them immediately because this is not a very real range of human experience, right? It's one register along a whole range of things. And the same on, sometimes I find my students, we teach them to be critical thinkers, yeah? And so they become critical of everything and they take on what I call the black hat, the negative hat. Yeah, where they're criticizing everything. And this becomes, when I was living in Spain and I lived the economic crisis in a different way to what Greece has lived, I saw what it did to people and what it did to me, and I felt how it changed me and how it made me bitter and angry and all of these things. And just understanding that emotions are one in a large set of a range of ways we can feel. Not to take away from that people shouldn't be feeling pain or shouldn't be feeling happiness, but it is all ephemeral, it all has its time and place.
And so I guess we can divide negative
and positive people. Are we dividing optimists and pessimists? I think we need to stop dividing into two groups and find something that we share, which was you guys were trying to do on an individual basis.
Like thinking people. Yeah, thinking and not thinking.
Ah, yeah. I think we are all negative people, so we will be divided.
Maybe critical is better than negative.
Critical.
It's hard to judge for myself.
Positive, I
think. Critical is funny like the person.
It's not negative.
Why don't we connect birthmarks? Everybody knows where they have a birthmark on their body on a very basic level. And we can find that who has a birthmark on their right arm, for example, or on their face.
Okay.
Or wrinkles.
What's that?
Let's connect your favorite wrinkle.
Okay.
Or
nothing.
Let's connect our favorite wrinkle. What is your favorite wrinkle?
The one here in the middle.
Because you're critical.
No, because
you delay that a lot.
No, because I'm just always doing this is my favorite one here, the deep one. Do you have any wrinkles?
I think yeah.
This one? That's not a wrinkle.
If I smile?
Oh, you have a dimple. Yeah, that's interesting there. Like a crater.
This. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's very original.
Okay, so, people have no wrinkle.
even by making these divisions, we actually, we're projecting, I guess, we control these things, and if one of these things identifies us, by choosing pain or not pain, I'll convince it or not.
No, it's not. It's pain. Pain is pain. Experience is experience. It's not that I choose to be pain. It's just happening. And I experience, and that's the fact.
But even saying that we have an identity, that we can even clearly define ourselves, is believing that we have a sense of control.
Identity is for what things can be changed by time and by interpretation, by the information you release, so I don't trust in identity either.
You know what's making it difficult for us to connect? Our own narcissism and our own individualism. That's the objective of why we're here for the hour, I think. To create some collective sense.
Is that the purpose of the things? You get connected and you get connected?
No, it's not. Why? Why should we go out as a collective?
Well, we don't have to go out as a collective, but we're meant to make some sort of musical piece according to the score.
Okay.
But why is it official? Why?
Sorry?
Why is it official?
Is a collective? What is a collective?
Why are you collective to me?
Sorry?
But why do you need to be to pace that you want to produce your collective? If there is a collective.
I mean, a collective could be a multiplicity of difference, yeah.
Does anyone want to make questions to people in Castle? Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? They are trying to to do something collective? Are you listening?
This is pretty easy, okay? We can connect our hands. We can do our ritualistic thing. And everyone is all happy.
What do you think they're doing?
I think we're trying to do something collective to get a common sense in the group, more or less.
Like a kind of ritual? Or...
What do you think about it? You.
Okay.
What do you think about what they're doing?
Are they for stone or what?
Yeah, it's the meaning of life.
The stone. Interesting is when people that are confident about what they're doing and like or confident in the space, in the sense that they have like their group and stuff like that, they tend to take over the situation. And of course, yeah, today we had a little bit of this in the end. I think we had an interesting talk, but after center point we lost attention. I like that part that we said the collective sad story about our disease, and I don't know if it was fully heard, but I think it created some tension with the lighting and stuff like that. I think that when we started questioning how we can connect and how we can and how and if we can overcome the narcissism and individualism of the capitalist system and ideology in order to connect, it was the part that I opened up the volume. And nobody tried to connect anymore with each other or with the people over there. And what they were doing was a suggestion of how to connect. And of course, we didn't have a suggestion. I mean, of course, yeah, we always say that this is a way of an approach like with ritualistic hippie approach, but about this room, about these people, what would be a way to connect? And since and up till now nobody has made a suggestion. What?
Why did you open the body?
To connect.
So I think that when you open the body, I mean, it stopped the interaction.
since I mean I was not here at the beginning, so I actually lost the introduction that you made, and I had this feeling that, you know, I came when there was already something going on, and I which is not making something forward, I'm not complaining about it, but still had this feeling that there was something going on, and I mean I would love to know that what you felt like in mind, how are you feeling the second.
What would you like?
What you had in mind?
In my mind, I had, of course, to open the volume as a provocative action, of course. I mean, I know that, I knew that it would stop the interaction in the room, and that's why I did it. But it is a question of, when we have a question of connecting and we have another room full of people and we just don't, we don't connect because there is no sound, and nobody questions why we don't connect or why we connect with each other, we want to connect with each other. And
but does it have to be verbal, the connection? It doesn't have to be verbal communication.
Of course not.
No?
No. But nobody paid attention to that. I mean, nobody had this will. To
but
connect.
But I think from the very beginning we had a strange dynamic of when we came in. The I don't know who's like the, there wasn't no dynamic of connecting two groups together. So there was like a separation in the beginning, and then I think actually when we had the last division, that was the step to connecting spontaneously, not like in a planned way. But that's when you turn the music on, and that kind of. Obviously, people just went silent or started listening, but it's. I think we actually reached the turning point where it could have happened. But I honestly don't think that collective is necessarily positive. I think it's individual development that could lead to positive.
Ah, and of course, we should have. We should have made the. Connection to the categorization and the connecting, like we, like to question if and how the categorization and the dividing into groups, like answering questions and stuff like that, but stereotypical questions in a way, is helpful to know each other or not in the,
How is other sections' results? Are they being connected successfully in the end? Like every different performance?
Sorry, I lost you.
How's the result of other sections? Are those people, are they being connected every time? Or different results?
What do you believe? What would you expect?
It's, there is a higher chance that people follow instructions and they get into groups and being connected.
We don't do the same thing every day. But still, yeah. Do you believe that there is a high possibility that people, totally strangers, come into this room for 1 hour and they get connected somehow?
I don't know. Maybe we need some more time, some more accurate basis, and
we could do some yoga or something ritualistic, and we would be perfectly connected. But this is not what we are trying to do.
I'm not asking for yoga too.
Obviously.
We could do drugs and that would connect us. Certain drugs would create a sense of collectivity or disconnectedness. Or disconnect.
Do you have any?
I didn't bring any, no. I'm not the type that would connect us. Have you guys tried using drugs?
Inside his performance?
Yes.
During the performance, no.
Before and after?
Yes.
We don't say it like that. I mean, we don't consider this performance as a result of something. And imagine that we are doing it every day.
With the rehearsal 7 to 1.
2.5 months.
7 to 1 times.
How many times?
70 times.
71.
Do you find yourselves using certain of the techniques that you used in other things, or do you really reinvent them every time? Do you find some repetition happening?